Good morning, students, and welcome to today's maths class. So in the previous class we had studied about properties of multiplication and division and also some shortcut methods for multiplication and division, right? So in today's class we'll be studying how to do word problems based on multiplication and division. All right, so before that let's just revise the properties of multiplication and division. So first, properties of multiplication. In the properties of multiplication, we saw that the first property, that is changing the order of the numbers. So when you're multiplying two numbers, even if you change the order in which you're multiplying those two numbers, the final product remains the same. Okay, so the product of two given numbers remains the same even if the order is changed. So for example, here they've shown 5 into 3 is equal to 3 into 5. So both are 15 only. Product of both is 15. Okay, so they're changing the order, but the final product remains the same. Then, next property. The product of three numbers is the same, even if the numbers are multiplied in any order. So, when you're multiplying three numbers, you can multiply them in any order. Your product will remain the same. So, they have multiplied 3 into 4 into 5 here. So, first what they have done, first they have multiplied 3 into 4. And then they have multiplied that product with 5. Same way, you can even multiply 5 and 4 first or 5 and 3 first. And then multiply the product that you get with the remaining number. So when you do that, your final answer remains the same. So when three numbers are there, the product remains the same even if you change the order. Okay, then the next property. The product of any given number and 1 is the number itself. Okay, so when you multiply any number with 1, the product remains as the number itself. So here they've done 25 into 1, which is 25. 73 into 1 is equal to 73. So you multiply any number with 1, you get the number itself as the answer or the product. Okay, then the last property, the product of any given number and 0 is 0. So you multiply any number with 0, your product is 0. Okay, your product is 0. Then, there are two more extra properties. So, if any number is multiplied by an even number, the product is even. So, when you multiply any number by a even number, then the product is also an even number. So, even numbers are those numbers that end with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0. Alright? And then when you multiply two odd numbers together, your product is an odd number. Okay, odd numbers are those numbers that end with 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. Alright, so these were the properties of multiplication. Now moving on to properties of division. Here, if we divide a given number by the same number, the quotient is 1. So when you divide any number by itself, then the quotient remains 1. Okay, the quotient remains 1 itself. So here the example they have taken is 63 divided by 63. So we are dividing 63 by itself. So the quotient is 1. Okay. Then if a given number is divided by 1, then the quotient is the number itself. When you divide any number by 1, the quotient will be the number itself. Alright, so here they have done 78 divided by 1. So here the quotient is the number, which is 78. Okay, then next one. Every division fact has two multiplication facts. So the division fact 15 divided by 5 is 3, and the multiplication facts are 15 is equal to 3 into 5 and 15 is equal to 5 into 3. Okay, so this division fact 15 divided by 5 is 3. It is a fact. So every division fact will have two multiplication facts. So what are the multiplication facts here? 3 into 5 is 15 or 5 into 3 is equal to 15. Okay, so this is the third property. Then the fourth property. When 0 is divided by any number, the quotient is always 0. So when 0 you divide by any number, the quotient always remains as 0 itself. So here 0 divided by 18 is 0. Then any number cannot be divided by 0. Okay, so you cannot divide any number by 0. It is not possible to divide any number by 0. Alright, so these were the properties of multiplication and division that we saw. Then we saw shortcuts to multiplication and division. So what are the shortcuts to multiplication? First we'll see. So multiplication by 10, hundreds and thousands. So when you multiplying any number with 10, 100 or 1000, what you do is, first write the number that is there as it is, and then write the number of zeros in the multiplier. Okay, so here when I do 7 into 1000, so first I'll write 7, and then in 1000 we have 3 zeros. So we'll write 3 zeros after 7, so that will be 7000. Okay, then multiplication by multiples of 10, 100 and 1000. So here they have taken examples. 8 into 20 is 8 into 2 into 10. So when you do that, first you can multiply the 8 into 2, so you will get 16, and then 10 has 1 0, so after 16 you can write a 0. Okay, so in order to multiply a number by multiples of 10, 100 and so on, we first multiply ignoring the zeros and then place in the same number of zeros in the product. Alright, so these are the shortcuts to multiplication. Then shortcuts to division. First, division by 10, 100 and 1000. So here, whenever you are dividing a number by 10, 100 or 1000, if you are dividing a number by 1000, then what you do is, now 10 has 1 0, correct? The last digit is 0. So only 1 0 is there. So what you will do, the last digit of the number is the remainder, while the remaining digits form the quotient. Okay, so when you divide a number by 1000, the last two digits form the remainder, while the other left out digits form the quotient. So when a number is divided by 1000, the last three digits form the remainder, while the remaining digits form the quotient. Okay, so these are some shortcuts to division. Now what we'll do is, we'll start with today's topic, that is word problems. Okay, so in word problems, what you do, they'll give you a kind of a story kind of thing, and they tell you to find, and they give you a problem based on that story, and you have to solve and answer that question. Okay, so let's see a few examples and solve the problems that are given in your textbook. Okay, so first one, a jewelry set had 314 pearls. How many pearls would be there in 72 such sets? Okay, so they are telling one set, jewelry set, has 314 pearls. Okay, so how many pearls it has? It has 314 pearls. So they are asking how many pearls will be there in such 72 such sets. So what you'll do here, for they have given you number of pearls for one, you have to find for 72 sets. So you will multiply the two numbers. So pearls in one set is how much? It is 314. So pearls in 72 sets will be 314 into 72. Okay, so we'll write the numbers in their place values like this, first in columns. Okay, and then we'll start multiplying. So first we multiply the ones place. So that is 2 here. Correct, we have 2 in ones place in 72. So when you multiply 2 fours are, how much is 2 fours are? 2 fours are is 8. So you'll write 8 in ones place. Okay, so we wrote 8, then we'll multiply 2 with 1. So when you multiply 2 with 1, 2 ones are is 2. So you write 2 here after 8. Then 2 threes are 6, so we'll write 6. Okay, so that is 628. Now we have 7 in tens place here, so that is 70. So you're multiplying 314 with 70. So what we'll do, we'll write that 0 here in 1's place first. Also, 0 of the 70 will write in 10's place, and then multiply with 7. So 7 4's are how much? 7 4's are is 28. So we write 8 and carry over 2 to 10's place. So 7 1's are 7 and 7 plus 2, 9. So we'll write 9 here. And then finally 7 3's are 21. So we write 21. Okay. Now what we do, now we'll add the these two numbers that we have got. So 8 plus 0 is 8, 2 plus 8 is 10, so write 10 and carry over 1. Then 6 plus 9 is 15 and plus 1 is 16, so write 6 and carry over 1. Then 1 plus 1, 2, and this 2 we write as it is. So we have 22,608 is the answer. So that is 22,600 pearls would be there in 72 sets. Okay, so there are 22,608 pearls in 72 sets. Alright, so next one. What should be multiplied by 35 to get 1400? Okay, so they are asking what should be multiplied by 35 to get 1400. So let's think what we should do. So now, for example, if I ask you what should be multiplied by 4 to get 12. Okay, you know that it is 3. 3 4s is 12 or 4 3s is 12. So it is, how do you get 3? What did we do? We did 12 divided by 4. So when you do 12 divided by 4, you get 3. Okay, so same way for this problem also. We will do 1400 divided by 35. So you know what number you have to multiply. Okay, so 35 divided by 1400. So here what you can do, you can write the first few multiples of 35. Okay, so when you do that, you see that 35 fours is 140. So we'll write 4 in the quotient place and do minus 140 here. So 140 minus 140 is 0. Then we have 1 0 left in 1400, so we'll bring that down. So 35 zeros are 0. So here the remainder is 0 and quotient is 40. So the number required is 40. So when you multiply 35 with 40, you get 1400. Alright, so this was an example for word problem on division. Now let's see the problems that are there in your textbook. So exercise 2.5. Okay, exercise 2.5 in your textbooks, page number 105. So we have 6 problems. Okay, so the 6th one is for your homework. Alright, so let's solve the first 5 questions. So what's the first question? 3,240 matchsticks are packed in 1 carton. How many matchsticks would be there in 58 such cartons? Cartons are nothing but boxes. Okay, boxes as they have shown here. Those are called cartons. So they are telling in one carton, there are 3,240 matchsticks. So they are asking in 58 such cartons, how many matchsticks would be there? So what will you do here? You will multiply or divide, you will multiply. Okay, so let's do the multiplication. Okay, so number of matchsticks in one carton is how much? 3,240. And how many such cartons are there? There are 58 cartons. So you will write like this, number of matchsticks in one carton, 3,240, number of cartons is 58. So total matchsticks will be 3,240 into 58. So first what you will do, you will multiply it with 8. So 8 zeros are 0, then 8 fours are 32. So write 3 carry over, so write 2 carry over 3. 8 twos are 16, 16 plus 3 19. Okay, 19, so carry over 1. Then 8 threes are 24 plus 1, 20. So 25,920. Okay, then we'll multiply it with 50. So we'll write down the 0 of 50 first and then multiply with 5. 5 zeros are 0, so we'll write one more 0. 5 fours are 20, so write 0 here and carry over 2. Okay, so then 5 twos are 10, 10 plus 2 12, so write 2 and carry over 1. 5 threes are 15 plus 1 16. So we have 25,920 plus 16,200. So when you add this, 0 plus 0 is 0, 2 plus 0 is 2, 9 plus 0 is 9, 5 plus 2 is 7, 2 plus 6 is 8, and 0 plus 1 is 0. So there are a total of 18,700. So number of matchsticks in 58 cartons is 1,87,920. Alright, so it is 187920. Okay, so this was the first question in exercise 2.5. Now, moving on to the second question in your textbooks. So the question is that there were 12 classes having three sections each in a school. Okay, so there are 12 classes. For example, you can take like from LKG to 10th standard. So those are 12 classes. Okay, and each class has three sections. Like first, how you all have division, right? Sections A, B, C. Like that, each class has three sections. Then they're telling in each section there are 26 students. Okay, in each section there are 26 students. They're asking how many students were there in the school. Okay, so first you will find how many students are to find how many students are there in school. Now what you will do, they have told you in each section there are 26 students. So first you have to find out totally how many sections are there. So for that, what you look, now how many classes are there? Number of classes is 12. And each class has how many sections? It has 3. So number of sections each is 3. Okay, then total number of sections, how you will find? You will multiply number of classes with number of sections. So 12 into 3, 36. Okay, so total number of sections are 36. Then number of students in each section. So how many students are there in each section? Each section has 26 students. So total number of students in the school would be 26 into 36. So when you do 26 into 36, first we'll multiply with 6. So 6 into 36, we'll write 6 and carry over 3. Then 6 twos are 12. So 12 plus 3, 15. So that is 156. Then 26 into 30. So 3, that 0 from 30 we'll write in 1's place. Then we'll multiply 3 6, which is 18. So we'll write 8 and carry over 1. 3 2s are 6 plus 1, 7. So 780. So when I add this, 6 plus 0, 6. 5 plus 8, 13. So write 3, carry over 1. Then 1 plus 2, 1. And plus 7, 9. So 936. So total number of students in this school is 936. Okay, number of students in the school is 936. Then 750 milliliters juice is available in a tetra pack. Find the amount of juice in 25 cartons containing 4 tetra packs each. Okay, so in a tetra pack, that is you get your cardboard box juices, right? Small, like your fruity and all that. So each tetra pack has 750 milliliters of juice. Okay, so they're telling find the amount of juice which is there in 25 cartons, and each carton has 4 tetra packs. Okay, each carton has 4 tetra packs. So first, so juice in one tetra pack is how much? It is 750 mls. Then how many cartons are there? 25 cartons, and in each carton, number of tetra packs in each carton is 4. So first what you will do, first you will find the total number of tetra packs. So to find that, you will multiply number of cartons with 4. So number of tetra packs in total is 25 into 4. So 25 fours is 100. So when you multiply that, you get 100. Then, so the amount of juice in 100 tetra packs will be how much? 750 into 100. Now, I have used the shortcut multiplication method here. So first what I have done, 75 I have written as it is, and then I have put the number of zeros after that. So we have 1, 2, 3 zeros. So that is 75,000 ml of juice is there in 100 tetra packs. Okay, so this was question number 3. Now moving on to question number 4. An amount of 48,975 was equally distributed among 75 workers. How much did each one get? So there are 75 workers in a company. Okay, and 48,975 rupees was equally distributed among these 75 workers. So they're asking how much did each one get. So to find how much one worker got, what you'll do, you'll divide. So total amount that is there is 48,975, number of workers are 75. So amount each worker got is 48,975 divided by 75. Okay, so to do that, you can write down first few multiples of 75. Then 75 6 is 450. So we'll do 489 minus 450 here. So first we'll write 6 here and 450 here. So 9 minus 0, 9, 8 minus 5, 3 and 4 minus 4, 0. So 39 you got. So we'll bring down this 7. So we'll have 397. Okay, and 75 into 5 is 375. So when I do 397 minus 375, 22 remains. Then I'll bring down 5, so I'll have 225 here. Okay, and 75 3 is 225. So that is remainder we are getting as 0, and the quotient is 653. So every worker is getting 653 rupees. Okay. So, a mini theater can accommodate 65 viewers. Okay, so there is a theater. It is a small theater. It has 65 seats. So, only 65 people can attend one show of at a time. So, if 1,365 people watch the show, how many shows were held? Okay. So, they're telling, they're asking how many shows were held. So, one show, only 65 people can be there. So how many such shows will be there so that 1,365 people can watch it? So number of people who watched the show was 1,365. And the accommodation in mini theater or the capacity is 65. So the number of shows will be how much? It will be 1,365 divided by 65. So when you do that, 65 2s is 130. So we'll write 2 in quotients place and subtract 136 by 130. So when I do that, 6 remains. So I'll bring down 5s. Now 65. You know that 65 1s are 65. So we'll do that. Remainder is 0 and the quotient is 21. So the number of shows that were held was 21. Okay, so 21 shows were held. So this is how you do the word problems. Okay, so these are word problem. Now question number 6, that is the 6,000 students participating in an event were accommodated equally in 12 blocks. So how many were there in each block? So they're asking in each block how many students were there. So to find out, what you'll do, you'll divide 6,000 by 12. So write the statements how we have written for all the other problems and then do the problem and solve the answer. Okay. So, this is your homework for today. So, complete your books and do your homework. I'll see you all in the next class. Alright, students. Thank you.